My name is Matt, and I'm a support engineer at Agilent Technologies. And today we're going to talk about how to wire two Agilent power supplies up for remote inhibit operations. So when a fault on one occurs, the other one shuts down, and vice versa. So what I have here is a N6705A DC power analyzer, and underneath it I have an N6700B module power supply mainframe. So the first thing we're going to look at is the wiring required to use this function. So let's take a look at that. So what we have here is a simple pictorial representation of the two 8-pin digital connectors that you'll be using to connect the fault inhibit operation. These connectors were included with the mainframe when they shipped. And if you want more information about how to do this, look at the appendix in the manual entitled Using the Digital Connector. So we're just going to use some different color markers to show the different wires you need to connect. So the first wire you're interested in is pin 1 on what I have labeled connector 1, which I'll be putting into my N6705A, is pin 1, which is the fault signal. So it's the fault output. So what you want to do is connect the fault output on connector 1 to the inhibit input on connector 2, which is going into the N6700B. You then want to connect the fault common of connector 1 to the inhibit common, which is connector 2's pin 8. And in a similar vein, you're going to want to connect pin 1, which is fault on connector 2, to pin 3 on connector 1, which is the inhibit input, and then pin 2 on connector 2, which is the common from the fault, to pin 8 of connector 1. And after you have that all done, you can plug the digital connector into the rear panel of the two mainframes, and then you turn the units on. So now we're just going to take a look at the settings you have to do on the front panel. This is the front panel display of the N6705A. We're going to start by pressing the menu key and then scroll down to the utilities menu item and hit the enter button and scroll down to the digital IO. So the two pins we're concerned about right now are pins 1 and 3. So we're going to take pin 1, which is set to digital I.O. right now, and set that to fault out. Then we go to pin 3, which is also set to digital I.O., but we're going to set that to inhibit in. And then close our menu here, and go back to the meter by hitting the meter rewind. So what we could also do here is press the settings button, scroll down to the protection, go to advanced, and there's an option here to make inhibit live or latched, as you can see here, or you can turn it off. We're going to leave it on live, but the difference between live and latched is that when it's live, when the inhibit signal goes away, the unit will automatically come back to its previous state. If it's in CV, it'll go back to CV, or if it's in CC, it'll go back to CC. Otherwise, in latch, it'll stay in protect until you go to the unit and clear your protection. So, now we're gonna take a look at the front panel of the N6700B and make pretty much the same settings. Okay, so here's the front frame of the N6700B. So to set this one up, we're going to start by pressing the menu button, scroll over to the system item, and then choose I.O. and digiport. And from here we can go to pins and set pin 1 to fault out. And then we go back to the pin selection, choose pin 3. And set that to inhibit in. So right now both supplies are set to use the fault inhibit operation. So we're gonna force a fault and see what happens. So in order to show the functionality of the fault inhibit, we're gonna force a fault on each of the two mainframes. So on the N6705A, what I'm gonna do is set channel 1's overvoltage protection to a value that's lower than the maximum value that the unit can put out, and then just program a value more than the overvoltage setting. So you're gonna go to settings, protection, and reset it down to 10 volts. And then get back to the meter view. We'll turn all our outputs on. And then we're gonna just go to settings for channel 1 here. The default's 15 millivolts. We're just gonna go on out and set 11 volts, which is higher than the 10. And you go to meter view, and you can see all our channels are in either OV, which channel 1 is because of the OV trip, and the rest of the channels are inhibit. So now we're gonna just go and clear that protection on channel 1. So set this down to 5 volts. Go back to settings, protection, clear all outputs. So everything's back to normal. So on the N6700B, we're just gonna show that, you know, this will shut off the N6705A. We're gonna go to do the same thing. So we're gonna hit menu, go to protect on channel 1. The OVP, we're gonna set down to 10 volts. And then go back. Just go back to the meter. I'm gonna set the voltage to 11 volts. Hit enter. So you can see channel 1 goes into OV. Channel 2 on this one's inhibited, and the two channels on top are inhibited. So we're gonna go just clear it, make sure everything goes back to normal. Menu, protect, and go to clear. Clear, and everything's back to normal. So that's just a quick tutorial on how to set the fault inhibit operation on the N6705A and N6700B, so that when there's a fault on one of them, you can shut the other one down. If you have any questions about this, please feel free to contact us at Agilent, and we'll be glad to help you. Thanks for watching.